So today I wanted to share with you guys everything that I am bringing in my travel luggage and carry-on bag for vacation. This is a video that I've been wanting to do, and I am so thankful that I am finally able to do this video for you guys. And I'm going to be sharing with you everything that I'm bringing and also sharing with you my outfit for the airport. So if you want to see this video, then just keep on watching. And also one more thing, I do not want any hate or negativity in the comments below. I did not get the baby moon that I wanted because of everything that's going on with the coronavirus. And this is just a quick 3-day, 3-night vacation to get away before my baby girl gets here. And I will be celebrating my 23rd birthday while I'm gone. So I'm really thankful that I was able to do this. I have been working so hard and so much since we got back to work after things started reopening. And I'm even thankful that I'm even able to take this trip. So please spare your negativity. You will see all of the precautions that I am taking to stay safe. And you know, I'm renting an Airbnb. I have a rental car. I am going to avoid people as much as possible and really just going to sightsee and mark some things off of my bucket list and try some new foods and just really get away just for a nice little trip before she's here. And I just don't want any comments like that saying, you know, why would you be traveling? I'm 31 weeks pregnant, but I am not high risk. So it is fine for me to be flying. And like I said, it's a trip the 14th through the 17th. So it's 3 nights, 3 days, and we will be home on Monday night. But I am turning 23 on the 15th. So this was just a little something to kind of celebrate my birthday and to get away for a little bit before everything gets chaotic again. So we are gonna first show you everything that I am bringing in my carry-on bag. I have quite a few things. I do pack my carry-on a little bit differently than most. That's because I like my valuables and my medicines and things inside of this bag versus my suitcase, because those things are important and you don't want them to get lost. So the first things that I'm going to be bringing is my purse. It's gonna have my ID, my debit card, my cash, any of my spending money, and just pretty much my valuables, things that I would not want to put in a luggage. Normally you do not put your purse in a luggage. So I just stick everything down into my carry-on and it works for me. So I will also be bringing my charger and headphones, which I don't have in this bag yet because I need those for the next couple of days. And another thing that I wanted to say that I'm throwing in here is, of course, keys and things to get back home after our trip. So the first thing I have, I just have an extra dress and a Nike hat that I didn't want to get ruined. This hat is brand new. It still has the tag on it. So I didn't have any more space in my suitcase. And I just wanted to throw that in here. So I have that. I am bringing a full container of Lysol wipes. This is actually what you could keep baby wipes in, but I have a ton of Lysol wipes in here to wipe the seats down and pretty much just keep where we are sitting clean. And I have these for me. I'm also going to give the father of my child one of these as well, because we may not be able to sit together. So I'm just kind of waiting out to see if we're gonna be able to sit together. I also have a mask. I am bringing 3 total just to have extras, because I don't want to be taxed on buying face masks. And if we run out, I have 2 additional masks, and I have one like this. And then I also have a cloth mask and just like a thinner spandexy type mask as well. I'm also bringing some hand sanitizer in this bottle, and this is travel friendly. It's 3 ounces, and then some Kleenex. So if I run out of Lysol wipes, I have tissues and hand sanitizer to keep the area clean. I also have all of my medicines. I have my vitamins in here. In here I have Tylenol and Tums combined. And then I have my iron medication as well. And then I am sticking my curling iron and my wand in here because they did not fit in my suitcase. I thought downsizing my suitcase would allow me not to pack so much, but I packed it to the brim without it being over 50 pounds. So I just put these in here just because my carry-on's not too heavy and I don't mind having a heavy carry-on. And then I also just packed some snacks, some crackers and some fruit snacks just in case I get hungry. Sometimes they offer food on planes, sometimes they don't. And with me being pregnant, it's always helpful to have some kind of snack on you because you never know when that hunger could strike. And then I will also be bringing a hair clip for my hair and a brush, but I still need a couple of these things out until we go. So I didn't want to pack that stuff away yet. So it matches with my bag. I also have a bigger one, and then it also has the luxury of rolling it. So I am going to show you guys a different angle because I don't feel like taking everything out of this bag. So give me just a minute. So in this pocket right here, I have my shoes. Ooh, that's a lot of cat hair. I do have a lint roller that I'm bringing as well. So I have my slippers, my white and tan sandals, and then I have my new sandals that you saw in my retail therapy haul. And then I also have socks, bras, and underwear back there as well. You guys know what those look like. I'm not about to show you what I'm wearing underneath. But that is what I'm putting in the first bag, or the first section of this bag. Nothing's gonna go in here. I don't really need to put anything in here, so I left that one empty. And then going into the actual suitcase. This is what we're looking at. So it is packed full. Up here, I have my toiletry bags. I have my makeup. And I have my blow dryer in here, like I told you guys I was going to put in here. And then I do have some makeup wipes, more makeup, extra toothbrushes so we didn't have to bring our own. And then down here are all of our toiletries, soap, body wash, shampoo and conditioner, floss, mouthwash, all of those things so that we didn't have to risk getting ours thrown away. I just packed two of everything so that we would have enough. And then I do have an extra outfit. This is a pair of biker shorts and a shirt. And then I do have this outfit right here, which is a pair of maternity pants that are like either jeans or capris with this green shirt. And then I do have a black shirt with another pair of maternity shorts. These outfits right here, I have two of them, two loose comfy shirts and two pairs of shorts for at nighttime, or if I just feel completely lazy and bummy, I don't have to actually wear an actual outfit. I can just pretty much put those on, or I can wear them to sleep. And then that's a foundation that I'm bringing. Everything is in clear baggies, just to prevent any issues from happening with TSA. I do not want to run into any security problems, so trying to be mindful about that. And then down here, I do have a dress. I rolled everything to save space. So I have three dresses here. And that is pretty much all, guys. That's everything in my luggage without taking everything out. This might be overpacked for 3 nights, but I wanted to have options, and it is going to be my birthday. So I want to make sure that I brought enough outfits for my birthday and for the entire trip. I did get my nails done as well. And I have a lash appointment tomorrow, so I am just treating myself this week. I also got my toes painted. I did white for a classic look. I got a whole pedicure today, and I really needed that. But this is everything that I am bringing you guys. I do have a little bit of space in here, like I said, and then in my carry-on as well. But I didn't want to overpack. I feel like I brought the bare minimum. It may look like a lot, but I did also pack toiletries for a dude as well. So that is everything in here. And that concludes this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope it gave you guys some ideas. If you are planning on traveling, just stay safe, wear your mask, wash your hands. If you can bring hand sanitizer and Lysol wipes, I would highly, highly recommend. I feel so much better now that I'm bringing those things, and I'm going to be fully prepared. And I'm not too worried about it. I know I'm going to have a great time. I'm eating lots of good food, going to a place I've never been before, and I get to do this all before my child gets here. So I'm really, really excited. I am going to be vlogging the entire trip. I'm not going to be on my phone much except for picture taking and vlogging, but I will have a vlog up this next week. So expect one around the 17th or the 18th, and then we can let the rest of August roll through, because I got lots of exciting videos coming up for you guys in the next 2 weeks. And that is pretty much all. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and I will talk to you guys in the next one.